Okay. Good afternoon, children. So now this period also we are going to do the revision from the chapter 1 numbers. Okay. While we do the questions from chapter 1, one more topic is left out. Which topic? It is races and games. Races and games. Okay. When we do the questions from the first chapter in the question paper, we'll be discussing that questions also. Okay. Now, those who have the question paper, take the question paper. Look at the first one. Okay. The first question, what is given here? The value of 5 dot circle 8, that is called a multiplication modulo. Okay. Dot circle means what we call multiplication. Multiplication by modulo means, what does it mean? You have to multiply, divide by 8 and give the remainder. Multiplication means, dot circle 8 means what you have to do? You have to multiply and you have to give the remainder. Okay, for example, suppose 2 dot circle 3 of 8 means what you will do? You add these two numbers, it is plus circle means add these two, 2 plus 8 mod 3. 2 plus 8 mod 3. Suppose it is given like this, 2 dot circle 3, 8 means what you have to do? You have to multiply these two and you have to take the remainder, mod 3. Okay, so in general, A plus circle M B means A plus B mod M, and A dot circle M B means it is A B mod M. It is A B mod M. Okay. Now, what will be the answer for this one? Check your answer. What is the answer for the first part? 5 dot circle 8. That means 5 into 11, isn't it? 5 into 11 and you divide by 8 and give the remainder. What is the answer? What will be the answer? Yes, make it fast. Yes, children, please give your answers at the earliest. Then only we'll be able to discuss as many questions. Yes, what is the answer? 7. 11 into 5 is 55. 55, when we divide it by 8, 8, 6 are 48. So the balance is 7. Okay, the remainder will be always less than 8. You'll not get a number which is greater than 8. Now look at the next part. For two distinct positive numbers x and y, which result is true? Which one is true? What we know? Suppose you are given two numbers x and y. Suppose we are given with two numbers x and y. Okay, for two positive numbers, note down this, for two positive numbers x and y, x plus y by 2 is the arithmetic mean. Okay, and what about the geometric mean? Geometric mean is given by root of g, xy. This is the geometric mean. And we know that arithmetic mean will be greater than or equal to the geometric mean. It will be greater than, arithmetic mean will be greater than or equal to geometric mean. So here, what will be the answer? Arithmetic mean means here, x plus y by 2, isn't it? Will be greater than or equal to geometric mean. Now by 2, if you cross multiply, x plus y will be greater than 2 times root xy. Is it correct? arithmetic mean is always greater than the geometric mean. Okay. Now look at the next one, third question. Listen to the third one. Is it okay? First two questions, is it okay? Anila, Mohan and Femina?
Yes, ma'am.
Now look at the next one. Third one. A person can row in still water at the rate of 8 km/h. Okay, in still water, he can row 8 km/h. If it takes him thrice as long to row upstream as to row downstream, then the speed of the stream is, okay, speed of a person can row in still water. So speed of the boat, it is given, isn't it? Speed of the boat is 8 km/h. We want to find the speed of the stream. We don't know the speed of the stream. You take it as x. So what will be the upstream speed? 8 minus 6. What is the downstream speed? 8 plus 6. Now what is given here? Look at the question. If it takes him thrice as long to row upstream as to row downstream. So what is given here? I think similar question we discussed earlier. Time taken for upstream is 3 times the time taken for downstream. Is that no? Time taken for the upstream is 3 times the time taken for downstream. It takes him thrice. It is given thrice. So time taken for upstream is 3 times the time taken for downstream. Time taken means, what is the formula we have learned? Distance by speed. Here distance is not given. We don't know the distance. Same distance only he is traveling. So distance by upstream. What is the speed? 8 minus 6 is the same distance. 3 into distance by 8 plus 6. Both the sides you can cancel. So we'll get 1 by 8 minus 6 is 3 by 8 plus 6. Cross multiply, simplify and find the value of x. Yes, what is the answer?
4 km/h.
Yes, it is 4 km/h. It is 4 km/h. Now look at the next one, fourth one. If x is congruent to -4 mod 3, then a solution for x is, what is the solution here? X is congruent to -4 mod 3. That means, yes, what you have discussed, A is congruent to B mod M means, what does it mean? A is congruent to B mod M. What does it mean? What is the definition? It means A minus B is a multiple of M. Is that no? A minus B is a multiple of M, or otherwise we can say A minus B is divisible by M. It is divisible by M. So now here what is given? X is congruent to -4 mod, what is the question? -4 mod 3. Then the possible value of X is, so what you can do? That means x plus 4 is a multiple of 3, isn't it? You should get x plus 4 as a multiple of 3. Minus 4, if you take it to other side, it will become plus 4. So when you add 4, what will be, what is the answer? What will be the answer? Yes. What will be that, sir? plus 4. When you add 4, you should get a multiple of 3. So if minus 2 plus 4, what is minus 2 plus 4? 2. Is it a multiple of 3? No, that is not possible, isn't it? Now look at the next case. 12 plus 4. 12 plus 4 means it is 16. 16 is a multiple of 3. Is it correct? No, isn't it? That is also not possible. What about the next case? 19 plus 4. Is it a multiple of 3? 19 plus 4. What is 19 plus 4? 23. That is also not possible. What about the next case? 35 plus 4. Yes, it is possible, isn't it? Therefore, the answer is 35. Chomlin, are you able to follow this?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Tommy. Now, is it okay? Shall we move on to the next question? Think the next question here. No, okay. So then the next one. So we have the question in that form. That's what we have to check. From 13, 14, 15. No, isn't it? From the first chapter till 18, we are not getting then. The next one is, I think it is in the question number 21. Question number 21. That is from races and games. Races and games. Okay, for the time being, we can leave that one. Okay, because if we don't know the formula, we have to recall it once again. Okay, by the end, if you count, time is there, means we can discuss it. Now look at the next one. I think this question only we discussed earlier. If the present time is 8:40 p.m., morning we stopped. Okay, I think I gave one question and I asked you to find the answer. How many of you did that one, tried that one? Current time is asked. Finished? What is the answer you got? It's the current time. Yes, Tomlin?
Nothing.
Yes, Aishwarya, what is your answer?
Ma'am, is it 11 a.m.?
11. Read the question. One second, you read the question.
5 a.m.
5 a.m. No, one second, you give read the question.
If the time after 6:40 hours from now will be 9 a.m., find the current time.
Yes, read the question, Aishwarya.
If the time, and can you hear me?
I think she got stuck. Okay, Karthik, read the question, Karthik. I'm not having the question with me. I think I kept that paper the next.
If the time after 6:40 hours from now will be 9 a.m., find the current time.
9 a.m., isn't it? So what do you have to do? You have to divide 6:40 by 24, isn't it? The two times will get 48, 12. Is it 120? Am I correct? So 24 into 4 means you get 96, 24 into 5, so 20. Is it 120?
Ma'am, isn't it 160?
Which one? Yes. Okay. 160. So then it's just 120. Then 24 into 6. 6 4s are 24, balance is 2, 12, I think 144. Okay, so I think it is 6 is possible. Am I correct? If you subtract it, is it 16?
Yes, ma'am.
So the balance is 16. So the question is, what you can do from this is the, okay. 16 hours after only we get 9 a.m. Is that no? After 16 hours. So what do you have to do? 16 minus 9. 16 minus 9. Minus 9, it is 7. Now look at this question, similar question. What is this question given here? After that, okay, look at this. Similar question only it is. If the present time is 8:40, then the time after 876 1 by 2 hours will be. So first you take the full part, 876. Don't take the fractional part. So 876, you divide it by 24.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, for the previous question, what was the answer?
Previous one. Okay. The remainder, is it like this? You got 16. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So 6:40 hours from now is 9 a.m., isn't it? 6:40 hours from now is 9 a.m. Is it the question like this? Repeat the question again, Karthik.
If the time after 6:40 hours from now will be 9 a.m., find the current time.
Find the current time. So 6:40 hours from now. So suppose we don't know the time, you take it as X. So X hours plus 6:40. X hours plus 6:40 only, you will get 9 a.m. Is it correct? So this 6:40, if you split it, what you are getting? 26 days plus remaining is 16 hours is 9 a.m. So this 26 days you can leave it. So X plus 16, you will get it as 9 a.m. So where will you find X? It is 9 minus 16 hours. You have to subtract it. Yes or no? So 16 hours earlier to that. So what will be the time? At 16 hours, you have to subtract it, 9 a.m. So if you subtract it, okay, one second, 9 a.m. If you subtract it, will it become 9 p.m.? Can we split this as 12 plus 4? Can we split this as 12 plus 4, 16? So a.m. will become p.m. So again, so 9 p.m. minus 4. Okay, so I think 9 minus 4. Is it clear?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, is it 5 p.m.?
Yes, it will be 5 p.m. Yes, earlier I gave a 7, isn't it? I think I subtracted 16 minus 9. It is 9 minus 16. It is 5 p.m. Okay. Is it clear? You can write like this. Present time, we don't know. Plus this much hours will give 9 a.m. Like that, you can write it and you can solve. Now, is it okay? Aparna, Aparna is there?
Yes, ma'am.
Now shall we move on to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Write the next one. Sorry. 876, 1 by 2 hours. So 876, when you divide it by 24, what is the answer? 876, you divide it by 24. 876, when divided by 24, find out the remainder. What is the remainder? Yes. Reminder is 12 hours.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So reminder is 12 hours. So what is the question asked here? Present time is 8:40. So the remaining is, so with 8:40 PM, you have to add 12 hours plus some more thing is there, isn't it? Plus half an hour is there, half an hour plus half an hour. So after 12 hours, it will become 8:40 AM. Plus half an hour. Plus half an hour means it will become 30 minutes. So 8:40 plus 30 minutes means what will be the answer? It is 9:10 AM. It is 9:10 AM. Okay. Is it 9:10 AM? Is it 9:10 AM? Okay. Anila? Shubham? Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it okay? The previous one, is it okay? Femina?
Yes, now
look
ma'am.
Now look at the next one. The next one is based on the partnership, isn't it? A, B and C enter into partnership. A contributes 1/3 of the capital, while A contributes as much as B and C contribute together. The ratio of their capitals is, the ratio of their capitals is, A contributes 1/3 of the capital, while A contributes as much B and C do. So we can take, so suppose we take the total amount as X. So here B contributes 1/3 of X. So X by 3. And what is given about A? A contributes as much as B and C. Okay, we don't know about C. What is C's contribution? Let us take C's contribution as Y. So A's contribution will be to as much as B and C. So it will be X by 3 plus Y. It will be X by 3 plus Y. So when we add up all the contribution, A plus B plus C, X by 3 plus Y plus X by 3 plus Y will be same as the total amount. Okay, if you add up all the contribution, it will be same as X. So here, from here, what you can do, we can simplify. Okay, when we simplify this, what you will get? 2x by 3 plus 2y is equal to x. So 2x by 3, 2y is equal to x minus 2x by 3. So we'll get 2y is equal to x by 3. So 6y is equal to x. So x will be 6y. So we want to find the ratio of their investment. A is to B is to C. A's investment is X by 3 plus Y is to B's investment is X by 3 is to, and what about C? Y. But here, look at here, X is 6Y, isn't it? X is 6Y. So we can write this as 6Y by 3 plus Y is to 6Y by 3 is to Y. So that is, if you cancel this, 3y is to 2y is to y. So the ratio is 3 is to 2 is to 1. The ratio is 3 is to 2 is to 1. Is it okay? Is it clear, Karthik?
Ma'am, can you explain it once more?
Okay. So the question is given like this, children. Take the question here. It is given A, B, and C enter into a partnership. A contributes 1/3 of the capital. We don't know the capital amount. So you take the total, that capital as X. Is it clear? So B is investing 1/3 of X. A contributes as much as B and C together contribute. That means A is contributing the sum of B and C. C's amount we don't know. You take the contribution of C as Y. So A will be contributing X by 3 plus Y. Is it okay, Anila? Is it Aditya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, when we add up all the contribution, it will be same as the total amount. So X by 3 plus Y, A's contribution plus B's contribution plus C's contribution will be same as the total capital. So 2X by 3 plus 2Y is equal to X. So from here we can write 2Y is equal to X minus 2X by 3. So from here we get Y is equal to. So from here we get Y is 6Y is equal to X. Now we want to find the investment of A, B and C. So A's investment is X by 3 plus Y. B's investment is X by 3. C's investment is Y. So if you convert everything in terms of X or everything in terms of Y, we can find the ratio easily. So what we did here we are getting X as a multiple of Y. So we convert everything in terms of Y. In the place of X, you put 6Y. So we get the terms in terms of Y, multiples of Y. So you can cancel Y. So the ratio will be 3:2:1. It is 3:2:1. Okay. Is it okay, Aditya?
Yes, ma'am.
Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now look at the next one. So the next one is from the topic relations. Okay, last year we have learned some relations and functions. Okay, from that topic on living. Look at the next question. 24th one. 24th one. Sorry, no, 23rd one. 23rd one now we discussed. Okay. So it is 3:2:1. Now look at the next one. M belongs to Z plus. That means M is a positive integer. M belongs to Z plus means what does it mean? M is a positive integer. Consider the relation RM. We define a relation A RM B. That means A is related to B if A is related to B if A is congruent to B mod M. That means A minus B is divisible by M. Okay. A is congruent to B mod M. Okay. A is related to B. A and B are related if A is congruent to B mod M. Okay. We want to check whether the relation is reflexive or not. Okay. Look at your children. When will you say relation is reflexive? If an element is related to itself, A is related to A. Okay, in relations and functions, okay, we have this topic, reflexive, symmetric and transitive. If an element is related to itself, then we can say it is reflexive. When will you say it is symmetric? Can you recall this one? When will you say it is symmetric? If A is related to B, implies B is related to A. If A is related to B, B is also related to A, means it is called symmetric. Next is transitive. When will you say relation is transitive? A is related to B, B is related to C, then A is related to C. Actually, okay. If these three conditions are there, means we call that relation as an equivalence relation. Note down this. Last year we had, okay. Equivalence relation. If a relation is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, we call this as an equivalence relation. Actually, this is from based on the plus one topic. A relation which is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive is called an equivalence relation. Now we have to check whether A is related to A. Is it possible? Check it. What is A is related to A? Whether A minus A is divisible by M? What is A minus A? Zero, isn't it? Zero is divisible by all the numbers, is or no? Therefore, A is related to A. Therefore, it is reflexive. It is reflexive. Will it be symmetric? A is related to B means what you can say? A minus B is a multiple of M. Is or no? A minus B is divisible by M. That means A minus B is a multiple of M. Therefore, can we say B minus A is also a multiple of M? Is or no? B minus A means how we can write? B minus A is same as negative of A minus B. So this is a multiple of M means this one also will be a multiple of M. So A minus B is a multiple of M means B minus A is also multiple of M. Therefore, it is symmetric. Now look at the transitivity. What about transitivity? See, no need to write this many steps. Okay. Now look at the next one, transitivity. I'm just recalling this what you have learned. Okay. Suppose A is related to B implies A minus B is a multiple of M. Now B is related to C implies B minus C is also a multiple of M. Okay, so now this is a multiple of M. B minus C is a multiple. So when you add this, A minus B plus B minus C. So these two will get cancelled. So we'll get A minus C is also a multiple of M. That means A comma C belongs to R. Therefore, it is transitive. It is transitive. Therefore, R is transitive. So a relation which is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive means it is an equivalence relation. Therefore, R is an equivalence relation. R is an equivalence relation.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is reflexive?
An element is related to itself. An element is related to itself means we call it as reflexive. An element is related to itself. A minus A is divisible by M. Okay, if an element is related to itself for all the elements, it should be true for all the elements in the set. Okay, actually, okay, anyhow, you note down these definitions. Note down these definitions, reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. I think in the last, okay, well, we are discussing the derivatives and all, we just went through it. Reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. If an element is related to itself, we discussed, is or no? Are you remembering that part? Relations and functions. What is a relation? Sometimes question will be asked. Okay, because we don't know. The 11th standard portion will be asked. Relations means a okay, it is a subset of Cartesian products. Function. What is a function? Function means a relation in which every element has a unique image. Okay, so now here we are just looking the relation. Relation means it is a subset of Cartesian product. It is a subset of Cartesian product. Okay, you note down this one because under this congruency modulo, the relation will be always equivalence relation. Under the congruency modulo, it will be an equivalence relation. Congruency modulo is an equivalence relation. If you take that relation, it is an equivalence relation. Okay, now look at the next part. which one we are discussing? Which one we are discussing, children? Can you give the question number? Okay, thank you. I got listen, children. So 23rd and 24th. Now look at the next one, 25th one. Listen to the 25th question. Three friends XYZ agrees to invest for time periods in the ratio 2:3:4. They invest for the time period 2:3:4. If their profit sharing ratio is 6:7:8, what is the ratio of their investment? What is the formula we have learned? Ratio of investment is equal to? What is the formula we have learned? Today morning we discussed this topic. What is the ratio of profit? Ratio of the profit is equal to profit is?
Ratio
of investment into time, isn't it? So what will be a ratio of investment? It will be same as ratio of the profit by time. Is that no? Here what is given? Read the question once again. Here it is said that they invest for 2:3:4. So it is the ratio of time. And the profit is shared in the ratio 6:7:8. So it will be the investment. Investment will be ratio of the profit by ratio of the time. So ratio of profit is 6:7:8. You have to divide it by the time. So what is the ratio of that time? The first one invest for 2, the next one for 3, the next one is 4. So that will be same as 3:7:3:2. Look at the option. Is there any such option there? No, isn't it? So this 3 is not there. It is not in fraction. Then what you can do? Multiply throughout by 3. So we'll get 9:7:6. So the option is B. 9:7:6. Okay. Is it clear? It is 9:7:6. Look at the next one. Here. Now take the next one. 41. Question number 41. Question number 41. A retailer buys 250 kg of rice, the part of which he sells for 10% profit and remaining at 5% loss. If the net profit made by the retailer in the whole transaction is 7%, so net profit is 7, then the quantity of rice sold at 10% profit is. So look at here. This is based on these allegations and mixtures. Okay, there we have two quantities, deep, cheaper and dearer mean value, isn't it? Is or no? If it is like this, D, C, D, M, we know that. What is the formula we have learned? D minus. What is the formula we have learned? D minus M by M minus C is equal to ratio of the cheaper quantity by dearer quantity. Okay, it is the same as ratio of, okay. So now look at here, listen all of you, it's a different question. It is given in a different way. A part of which he sells for 10% profit and remaining at loss. Okay, so the loss, the smaller one only we take it as cheaper. So loss, I'm taking it as -5. Okay, loss, I'm taking as -5. It is loss, that is why I take negative. Smaller one only we take it as cheaper. And which one is costlier? It is 10%, so it is 10. Look at the mean. Mean means it be the middle value. You get 7. We take this as 7. So D minus C, D minus M, 10 minus 7 by 7 minus of minus 5 will be same as, it will be same as, is it 3 by 12, which is 1 by 4. So cheaper quantity, we will take 1, dearer means 4. So total, how many parts are there? Total parts is 5. If you take 5 parts, 1 part cheaper and 4 parts dearer. Now what is asked? Okay. The quantity of rice sold at 10% profit is, you want to find, okay, then the quantity of rice sold for 10% profit. So that means we want to find 10% profit means we want to find what is the dearer quantity sold. So it is dearer ratio, it is for dearer, the ratio is 4, isn't it? 4 by 5 of 250. 4 by 5 of 250 means 200 kg. It is 200 kg. We want to find the quantity of rice sold at 10% profit. 10% profit means it is same as the dearer quantity. We want to find what is the quantity of dearer quantity is sold. So total parts is 5, dearer is 4. So 4 by 5 of 250, it is 200 kg. Okay, so listen, this ratios and mixture question, when I went through it, I got one different question. Write down that question. Write down this and try this question. Similar to this, okay. Instead of items, it is given as boys and girls. Okay, whenever you are given comparing like this, the quantity which is less in number, you should take it as C. Suppose the number of boys is given as less means that must be C. Bigger number is for girls means that is D. Middle value, average value, you have to take it as M and you have to find the ratio. Okay, look at the question, write the question. In an examination out of 500 students, in an examination out of 500 students, 70% boy and 80% girls are passed. In an examination out of 500 students, 70% boy and 80% girls are passed. If the total percentage was 76%, if the total percentage was 76%, find the number of girls. Find the number of girls. Can you try this? In an examination out of 500 students, like the previous one, smaller ratio, you take it as for C. In an examination out of 500 students, 70% boy and 80% girls are passed. If the total percentage was 76%, find the number of girls. Try this one. Okay. Now one more question is there. Look at the question here, pipes and cisterns question. Two pipes A and B fill a cistern in 8 hours and 12 hours respectively. The pipes were opened simultaneously, takes 12 minutes more to fill the cistern due to leakage. So there is a leakage. It takes 12 minutes more to fill it. Okay. So if once the cistern is full, it will get emptied due to leakage in dash hours. At what time it will get fully empty, that is what we have to find. So look at here, first pipe takes 8 hours and second pipe takes 12 hours. So what is the part of the tank filled by both A and B? Part filled by both A and B. How will you take this? 1 by 8 plus 1 by 12, isn't it? If you take the LCM and simplify, it is 24 into 3 into 2. So it is 5 by 24. Okay. So that means it takes 24 by 5 hours to fill the tank. 24 by 5 hours. That means it is same as 4 hours, 48 minutes to fill the tank. If you keep it together open, It takes 4 hours, 48 minutes. Convert that into minutes. 24. Okay. 24 by 5 means what you will get? 4 hours plus 4 by 5, isn't it? To convert this into minutes, what you will do? Into 60. That is how we get 4 hours, 48 minutes. Okay, now what is given? It takes 12 minutes more to fill the tank because of the leakage. So what is the total time now? 4 hours, 48 plus 12. So total time taken will be 5 hours because of leakage. Now the total time taken is 5 hours. Now what do you have to find? Now what do you have to find? So what is, okay, in how many hours is needed to empty the tank? That means what you will do? What you will do? Full part is, if you take the full part, it is 5 by 24. It takes 5 by 24 part to fill. And what about the leakage? It's reciprocal, minus 1 by 5. If you simplify this, you'll get the answer. That one will give the part. Okay. Is it clear? So from here, you find out what is the answer. How many hours is needed? Okay. Is it clear, children? Try to complete this and go through the questions. Once again, solve such questions and come. Okay. Okay, children, with this, I wind up the session now. Thank you.